All right, so last time you guys spent a fair amount of time meeting the merfolk. You went to an underwater temple that was dedicated to Ileana the Huntress. There, Lily, you guys encountered a strange kind of shark humanoid that believed himself to be Ileana's chosen. You guys had a brief encounter with him that ended with you all victorious. Afterwards, Lily had kind of a private moment with her deity and seems to have undergone some kind of change. She lost anew. You guys are not 100% sure what is going on there. Only time will
Amen.
tell. After that, you returned to the Merfolk Village. You were rewarded for the good work that you had done. And they have pretty much told you guys that you are free to hang out around the city and do whatever you like. They seem to love having you. And you guys kind of ended with, I know Gabby was spending some time with the priests and priestesses of Freya. And the rest of you kind of, and everyone had to deal with kind of a little outburst that happened from Lily right at the end. And that's where we're at right now. You guys currently have information on two of the Seasingers that the Murrow were inquiring about. There are supposed to be three more.
Are we at a
Don't read off the
cantina or something?
What was that?
What's our location in the city?
We're like in the middle of a street.
Yeah, you guys are just kind of in the middle of the street
Yeah, we're
where,
just standing here.
yeah, Lily kind of had this strange incident. And then,
Everyone walk off and leave the city on like bench
yeah, I think
or.
everyone's just kind of hanging around nearby. I know Gabby went back to the temple.
Yeah, I'm praying with the girl. The Muppet?
The grill.
The girl? I keep forgetting her name. I should probably write it down.
Oh, you're fine. Here, let me pull out the magical book of secrets. Marin
Actually,
spell
has the
slot.
book of
Marin.
names that he wrote.
Okay, I'm keep that on my new tab.
Well, you can't have motherfuckers changing their names.
You right.
Unless they're supposed to.
Like a
Da da da.
All right, so what would you guys like to do?
So, after Gabby is done praying, he will head over to Lily, wherever she is.
I still have Mark's get on.
Oh. How long does that last?
The rest of the hour.
Oh. I walk over to you. Where are you at again? You're just in the middle of the street?
Yeah, I'm sitting on whatever is available.
Okay. I tap your shoulder.
And just for me, is this city underwater or
Yes.
like in a pocket of air?
Yeah, no, you guys are underwater and you have been given a kind of boon by the merfolk that will allow you to breathe as long as you stay in proximity to the large pearl.
Great.
We're swimming. Your goat's also swimming.
My goat's like, what the fuck?
Yeah, the goat's just hanging out with a little bubble around its head. It's chewing on a piece of grass that you guys have no idea where it
What the
got.
sh? It's seaweed.
Seaweed, man.
See? Straight man thinks alike.
So I turn to Gabby.
I kinda like hold out my hand.
I place my hand in yours.
Ah, you're sitting, right?
Yeah.
So I do that nice thing where I lift you up. Not like gently, like a gentleman.
You like lift
And
my arm and I'm still sitting and like, what do you want?
and I lead you to the temple.
Okay, I follow.
And I go inside.
And just so I know, what are the rest of you
Is
kind of
there
doing as they're doing this?
There's an inside, right?
I think I had already went back because I thought that crap, I'm forgetting all the character names now.
No one
Man, I
help him.
can't remember. Well, that's all right. I'll just call them Ranger then.
Hi,
Lonely
Lily.
Texas
Lily.
Ranger. I thought
Select
that
unlock.
Lily was just playing a prank and being annoying, so I just left.
Okay.
Basically, I
Exactly.
just went back to the hall where the merfolk were.
The temple.
No, I think he's
Yeah.
talking about, oh, the temple. I thought you were talking about where all the magical items were.
Okay, so what are you guys doing inside the temple?
Okay. Uno momento. And
I don't know.
Do I see any gems?
Oh, you son of a bitch.
What was that?
You're in the temple?
Do I see any gems in the temple?
You see gems kind of inset, in, like, inlaid into statues and things like that.
So I'm just, like, admiring and taking in all this.
Okay. Yeah, no, it's going to be very, very beautiful stonework, something that you would definitely appreciate. Very, very kind of intricately carved statues.
How long does it take to take off, like, a top part of a splint nail?
A couple of minutes.
We can look it up, but, you know, a little while. A
few minutes, yeah.
Okay. I say, and Sylvan, help me with this. I start taking it off.
I don't know how.
Son of a bitch.
I've never seen armor that big.
Heavy armor takes...
Are you seeing where the ones with those straps?
I think it's 10 minutes for...
Oh, is it 5? ...fully take off.
Okay.
Yeah, it's 5 minutes.
I just need to take off the top part.
Okay. It'll be about 3 minutes.
Okay. I take off the shirt of dousing.
Which looks like a normal shirt in the water.
It just looks like a normal shirt, yeah. And I take out the digging spoon, an unknown potion, and the shard. And I fold it up all nicely, and I put it in, like, presenting, and I bow, and I hand it to her.
Wait, you just gave him the shard?
Yeah.
I, sort of stare at you.
Wait, he's giving it to Lily, I think, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, to Lily, I'm sorry. I thought he was giving it to his main squeeze.
No. That would be fantastic, though.
That would have been funny.
Awkward silence.
As you were saying? Yeah.
Okay, I had to give some.
Say
and Sylvan. I like it here, and I haven't really been able to find a place where I could feel at home, even though this is completely different than the forest, of course, but I don't know, I feel at peace, especially in this temple, and I think I would like to stay. So I'm giving you all of what I have acquired to help you. I know you don't want to stay here like I do. And those could help.
You want to stay here? Of all places?
Yes.
Is all in Sylvan.
Yeah. I feel connected here. Myself, if you could say. This close to Freya feels right, you know?
How bright is it down here? Like, how's the sunlight?
There's no sunlight, but they do have gems kind of making up makeshift kind of street lights and things, and they do have kind of glowing gems within the room that's lighting it up.
And at this point, you see my goat look quizzically at you and poop out of its butt. Three little pellets, and they go floating away.
I sure hope it wouldn't have pooped out of somewhere else.
Did it just poop in the temple?
Maybe.
Probably.
It did it?
Guiding bolt! Guiding bolt!
I was going to...
Yeah.
Guiding bolt the fuck out of it. No. I get a little twitch in my eye, and I start, like, my neck starts shaking. I turn around, I'm like, it's okay. I slowly turn around, all smiley and shit, but still with twitchy eye.
Hey, you can see that Merit is actually smiling warmly at the goat. She thought it was kind of funny.
Nothing can shake this tree.
And I slowly walk over and I kiss Lily on the forehead and I put my hand on her shoulder and I walk out. And I leave. I walk away.
Like a damsel looking at her knight as he leaves to the sunset, Lily walks and leaves.
Even though it's literally like do 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 do,
but you're like slowly like swimming away.
I mean, oh wait, I go back over and I pick up my splint mail and I walk out with that. My splint mail, goddamn.
Gotta keep his sexy armor.
Yep. So confused.
Okay, and as that kind of happens, the Marin, the kind of head merfolk, as you have met her, kind of drifts forward, and she's like, I must admit, he hadn't mentioned anything to me, and I can assure you all that he will be well looked after here, if that is truly what he desires. Though, I must also say that there is one among us that came to us recently with some grievous injuries and unfortunately has taken some time healing. If you all need somebody else to head out with you and help you with your adventures ahead, I'm sure that this individual would probably be interested in leaving here. It's just not the right place for them. They belong... I'll let them explain it. But if you are interested in having an additional person leave with you, I can direct you their way.
No, thanks. I'm kidding.
No, it's up to you.
Fuck that guy.
Yeah, fuck you.
No. I say, we may as well meet them, but we'll have to make sure that their goals align with our own.
Very well, just let me know when you all are ready, and I will take you that way.
Well, I'm pretty much ready whenever.
Oh, I just didn't know if anybody wanted to talk about what just happened. Okay.
In character, I don't really know them that well. And they also have no idea what they just said.
So. Right, you guys all just saw Gabby... basically take the valuable items that he has collected and hand them to Lily and then swim off. So.
I try to walk. Like, I'm just, like, paddling my feet and trying to stay upright.
I just imagine breaststrokes.
Or dog okay. paddle. So, after a... takes a couple of minutes, she kind of leads you to a building that's actually similar to the one that you all stayed in. You can see that similarly, this one also seems to be some kind of guest house. It also has a pocket of air kind of inside of it, and she just kind of motions towards the bubble entrance, if you will, and kind of he lies within there. He's a rather friendly sort, at least he has been to us. I'm sure that it should be a lovely time. If any of you need anything, just let one of us know. And then she heads back towards the temple.
Over my armor.
Okay.
Pretty much it. I'm looking to Lyric for guidance.
I sort of give a shrug. that was most interesting, but we can't persuade someone to change their lifestyle so easily. I suppose we should just might as well see this new person. Maybe, hopefully, they'll be of assistance.
I have no idea what's going on, sure.
So I guess I go on to where they're leading us.
Okay. And yeah, and inside you guys see a very, very sturdily built man. He is kind of very, very stout in nature, like very definitely looks like a very kind of warrior type in a way, but very, very regal at the same time, kind of almost chiseled features that remind you of a marble statue. And you notice that the eyes kind of have an interesting light to them as well. And I will let you guys and Brandon take it from here.
Hello? Who might you be? My name is Lyric, and these are my companions. We had heard that perhaps you could be of assistance to us.
Kind of glances at everyone. Hi. Oh. He, like, scratches his forehead. My name is, Cranor. Hi.
Greetings, Cranor. Why is it that you're here, may I ask? And also, where it is that you seek? We had heard that you felt as though you didn't belong.
Well, funny. Funny question, I think some would say. I don't remember coming here. But I do know I don't want to be here.
Well, that makes sense. You see Beric straining their hardest to not just be like, what the fuck is up with this person?
Yeah.
And you can see he looks a little bit confused as he's explaining this. He genuinely seems a little bit lost himself.
Well, tell us a little bit about yourself. I'm sorry, I already forgot your name.
Cranor. That was what. Yeah.
It's Cranor.
Yes.
This guy's fucking weird.
I sort of give a nod, and I turn to him. Yes. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Are you experienced with combat?
He like looks at himself and looks at the armor and the longsword. I do believe so. Yes.
And anything specifically you're good at?
I can heal people.
Welcome to the party.
How good are you at combat? You got quick reflexes?
Kind of.
Like Vesta, don't ice my venom.
Oh shit, do you actually?
Yeah.
Oh, it looks like you miss.
Yep, that will be a miss.
Do I get surprise or advantage surprising?
No, because you're like, so is your reflexes good? It's like, oh shit. Oh, God.
Well, basically Cranor doesn't move and the knife just sails harmlessly past him. And he just kind of looks at the knife that looks back at you.
Does he flinch at all?
Doesn't need to.
No, I'm just like, the fuck? I'm like,
so the ice knife goes past him and I'm like,
it just kind of clinks off the
battle.
Wall.
He's in. Not even flinched. He's seen battle.
Whether or not he wants to join.
I don't know what that was for. What
kind of sorcery was this?
Any other questions?
Lily's thinks in the back of the group, like, that didn't work as well as I wanted to.
I do believe you guys do not want to be here, right?
Yes. Very much so, although we still have a mission to complete, unfortunately.
I hate the water.
Oh. Me too, it's all wet. But water is essential for life. So.
Well, to be fair, they haven't proved that water is wet. Oh. I'm just kidding about that.
Well, it is a necessity for life. You know, people drink it, and I should stop talking.
Oh, there's no reason to hush yourself.
Okay, so it is essential for life. A lot of humanoids and races need it to survive. And for plants, like seaweed and mostly other plants, they need sunlight. And I should... All right. Continue.
Do you know where you're from at all?
He, like, looks... If someone could think really hard, he's doing it. Like, give a face.
He looks so focused.
By the way, can I tell this guy's human or what?
You can give me...
Ooh.
Check would that be.
I'll just give an int check and then...
Yeah, let's just do an intelligence check.
This is a save with... Oh, wait, it's actually not the same because I have...
Insight? I'm a bard traveler. Do insight, actually.
Oh, I'm good at that.
Show me your true self.
Apparently not that good.
So, Lyric, I mean, you're just very thrown off by kind of the awkward personality. Lily, you get the impression that he is definitely not human or kind of... one of something you're familiar with. There's definitely something weird going on with him, but it's not something you're familiar with.
Most interesting.
She just notices that and goes back to inspecting her hand.
Yeah, well, especially the eyes. Especially the eyes in particular would catch your guys' attention.
We are just about to go meet up with some very nasty... can't remember the name for some reason.
Murrow.
Is that something that would interest you?
Yeah, Shark Boy Lava Girl.
Honestly, I haven't been able to do anything for the past... Well, I really had nothing to do. I need friends.
Have you been out of that armor since you've been here?
I don't remember.
Right.
But all yeah, right. Sure, that sounds nice.
I sort of turned to the others. Could you just give us one moment, please?
To us?
Okay.
No, I'm sorry. I start turning toward the others while I'm saying this. And then, so I sort of take everyone aside a little bit and I say, this guy's really weird. I'm not sure what to think of him.
How the fuck do you get down here not knowing you're here?
Well, it's possible maybe they were drowning here and that caused them to have amnesia. I'm not sure. We could ask the merfolk if they know anything about it. Although I'm sure they probably would have told him.
I mean, this guy can barely remember his name, much less how to fight.
Well... there'll be no harm if we bring them with us and then they just get themselves killed. No harm to us, that is.
You know, yes, do you know you are not? You're talking pretty loud.
Ignore him. You know, Lyric, I expected better of you, and I'm proud of you.
Well, if you remember, I was a part of spy operations. I can be cold-hearted when the time arises.
You shouldn't admit that.
Damn it. Fuck off.
Well, I mean, I'm very open with my friends. I sort of give a glare at you as I say that. So, we might as... Do you say that?
Yeah.
You...
I don't even know what he said.
I sort of just shake my head and I say, you've been keeping secrets from us.
Haven't we all?
Some more than others, but my point is, I'm open to those that I trust. Anyways, that's neither here nor there. We can discuss that later. Give this man a shot, and if he gets himself killed, then that'll be that.
If you wish.
Yeah.
All right.
Since he just comes out of nowhere in the middle of it, yeah.
And then the goat says, "Meh."
What about Xemnas and Dev?
They're just kind of... You can see that they're kind of very quietly watching the whole thing. They just...
Just broing out.
They're doing tiefling things.
Oh, yeah, fuck them.
It's weird how the two tieflings are in here.
Yeah, they're both plotting against the rest. The Sylvan speakers.
They're locked in their bedchambers together.
But, yeah, I guess I walk back over and I say, welcome to the team. We're gonna be going on our first mission pretty soon. And we'd like to have you come with us, you know, just to see how things go.
Let's go. However,
if, because I hope you understand when I say this, because we don't know you very well, this is going to be a very delicate situation we're walking into, and I'd appreciate it if you could speak as minimally as possible.
Oh. Okay. Pull out my shard. You got any of these laying around?
I do not believe so.
No?
Oh. I don't think so.
He just kind of pats himself down?
Yeah, I was going to say, he like pats himself. Nope.
I put it back in my pocket. Minus 5 points.
For Gryffindor.
He literally, like, she literally like tallies
up. Like, leans to Lyric, like, what does that mean? Did I do something wrong?
I sort of shrug, honestly, and I say, I have no idea what that means. But let's hope it's something good.
Oh, my notebook is fucked, and we're in water, damn it!
Yep.
And as everybody else is talking, I kind of mutter myself to the side, and create an illusion of a small sun about 30 feet away from us.
Okay.
Beautiful. It accomplished nothing.
I have no idea what that was for, but okay.
I just want to see.
I checked the weather. Is it sunny? Cloudy? Rainy? Hmm?
Yes, now it is sunny due to that, that illusion.
It appears to be sunny.
Alright. I have a glowing ball in my hand, like a sun. I hold it up next to it. That was two.
I'm sorry, no, what are they doing again? I'm so confused.
It accomplishes nothing.
Okay. You guys can lead the way. Yeah.
Alright. So, we... I guess turn to the others and I say, what's the plan of attack here? We should speak whether or not we're going to rat out the merfolk.
I thought we were kind of decided that it wasn't our problem how this ended.
Yes, but the only problem is we need to acquire the Merle's shards.
Oh yeah, we were going to...
Yeah, all they wanted was the information on where the Sea Singers are located.
Yeah,
we were going to... be fair, that information isn't necessarily going to doom the Merfolk.
No, thought we were going to inform the Merfolk that we were going to do this so they could set a trap beforehand. And they were going to go get it and leave.
The only problem I can see is if perhaps the Merrow decide to wait to give us our prize until after the fact, and then they just don't give it to us because they get sprung into a trap.
Well, I said they'd give it to us when we gave them the information, as far as I understand.
I have altered the deal. Pray I don't alter it further.
I'm sorry.
Is there any way we can make the deal mutually beneficial to both of them?
I think that's what we explained is really the only way where it could, in a way, be mutually beneficial. I guess, in a sense, it would be mutually non-beneficial. In that they do learn the locations that were there, but then the merfolk also get to defend themselves from an attack. I say it's worth a shot, to at least see if maybe they'll give up the shard in exchange for just the information. They can ask us all they want, zone of truth, whatever, and we'll be telling the truth. But I suppose he probably doesn't remember. Do you perhaps have the ability to cast zones of truth?
Cranor. All things again. I don't think so.
Splendid.
Is it? Did I do something good?
We'll say that, yes.
Thank you.
So, I suppose we might as well go in and...
She said it again, what does that mean?
We'll tell them the locations, and then we get our shard, hopefully, and we leave. If they don't give it to us, we beat the shit out of them. Not immediately. Yes, and they did not say that they had to confirm first, so technically that is part of the deal.
It seemed like they were true to their word.
They did seem reasonable, to be fair. Let's, I say we go, and if we can't convince them otherwise, then we will have to fight our way to the shard.
So, to the merfolk first?
Yes. I'm not going to go and tell them. You guys can, because this way, if they do ask whether or not we told them, I won't know whether or not you told them. And therefore, I will not be lying when I tell them otherwise. So you do what you're going to do that I don't know what's going to be, and then we'll meet up on the way out.
Okay.
And who are you all seeking out?
There's a reason. What's that?
Who in particular are you guys seeking out from the merfolk? I know you've met a couple of people.
I'm going to go back to the songstress that Gabby...
Marin!
Okay. That I remembered. Yep, that'll be Marin spell song.
Yep. And I guess the lyric just kind of goes off towards the marrow.
It just kind of hangs out, waiting for you guys.
Yeah, I'm just waiting on the outskirts.
Oh, okay. Yep, so I go back. Gabby is now shirtless, just sitting there. Beautiful.
He has his armor back on. Okay.
That's even worse. So I approach the songstress.
Yes, hello, how can I help you?
Before my group and I arrived in your city, we were approached by the Murrow.
Ah, I hope that it wasn't too bad of a meeting.
Ah, they were quite pleasant, actually, but they hold an item in which we need, and the only way to obtain it is to trade them information related to you.
You see, she kind of gets this strange look on her face for a moment. She's like, and what information were they looking for?
They want to know the location of all your songstress. I assume they want to know where your powerful casters are. So they could probably
imagine. I imagine they would. But you came to tell me this. I assume that perhaps you intend on doing something else then?
My plan is to inform you so that you may gather, and when they approach to ambush you in secret, you can fight back and put it into their, well, attempt at reclaiming the city.
Very well. I appreciate this, and it It had to have taken a lot of courage to come in here and tell me that. I appreciate you doing what you've done, and I can assure you that we will be ready. You can see that there's kind of a solemn, sad look in her eyes as she says that.
Of course, this warning of ours is saving many of your lives, if not all of them.
Where are you going with this train of thought?
Yes, I am very confused also.
Extortion.
Exactly. I was just wondering if we aid you in the battle, and we've already assisted you by forewarning you, you could help us arm ourselves from some of those artifacts you hold. We have a long journey ahead of us and many perils we may face.
I tell you what I can do, young Lily. In addition to the fact that we helped make sure that you all didn't drown on your way into the city, we will also award you some gems for the information that you have given us. If you wish to have anything more powerful, you will need to stay and help us deal with the Murrow, unfortunately. I can't be giving away our prized artifacts so easily. Unfortunately, that is how we maintain ourselves and get the supplies that we need. But I do appreciate what you all have done here, and I would be willing to give you all some gems as compensation.
I will consult with my friends and give you my answer momentarily.
Very well.
Then I walk back to where Lyric is with everyone and have a big group meeting.
Is this related to things that may or may not be occurring? As in a sort of talking that you had.
There is potential to gain more than we expected should we spend more time here.
I like leaning. She haggled. I'm not like Jew. Like, my face is actually really stern.
Okay. You know what? I'm actually very good at lying anyway. I should be okay, hopefully. What is it that we have to gain?
I told her that we will assist her in the battle if she would reward us appropriately. And she said she would give us some of her magic artifacts should we assist her and her people. We'd get the gem or the shard from the Murrow.
Well, something from these people. Our quest is to acquire powerful magical items to bring back. So we would be doing our duty if we do this. I say that we accept. And sure. I sort of look to Fizzy. What do you think, small one?
Do they have any rubies?
I just reach over and lightly pat Fizzy on the head. Yes, I saw them. They have many rubies.
The merfolk are very interested in gems of all types.
Yes, in fact, I have one of their gems around my neck.
So does Dev.
I'm in.
It's decided then.
Cool. I'll be right back. And I scurry along back to her doing the breaststroke.
Mm-hmm.
I think I should follow. And I do it too.
You can mimic it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
all right. And yeah, as Lily and Cranor kind of come in, you see that Marin kind of turns to Cranor. It's very pleasant to see you out and about. I'm glad that you were able to come to some sort of arrangement with our new friends here. They've been abundantly helpful with us.
Yes. Do you know what -5 points means?
I'm afraid I do not.
Okay. Thank you.
It's You're a welcome. Mathematical value lower than zero.
And more helpful we shall be, as we will aid you in your fight.
Very well, I appreciate that. So, what is your plan next, then? Are you going to return to the Murrow and give them something to draw them out?
We're going to give them the information they seek.
Okay. Well, you need to tell us a place in which you will gather for them to come.
And, yeah, you guys were supposed to find out the location of the four sea singers, and basically she gives you four locations that would make sense to the Murrow for you to tell them.
Mm-hmm.
Go to write them down, realize my paper is ruined.
So I write them down in my noggin.
Yeah, basically it's important places like temple, town square, palace, and like the
brothel.
Like the bank, if you will.
Yep, so I nod and I say thank you. We will do our best to defend you.
I will rally pull for it once, and I look forward to your return.
And then we give the Murrow information that we told them Murrow. About it, and now we're going to attack their undefended points. No. Alright, so yep, I suppose we are headed toward the rendezvous point of the Murrow now.
Put on my... my neck sucking thing.
Yep, that is going to require the slugs if you guys want to go there, because you do not have potions.
Yeah,
so. Do I have that?
Oh, you don't have one.
They would have Gabby's.
No.
Yeah.
Gabby gives us his as well.
It was kind of hidden in the bundle.
Yeah.
A disgusting slug.
Yeah, like a nasty shit.
I lift it up.
Put it on your neck.
What is this?
Just slap one onto his neck.
And as you slap it onto his neck, there's kind of... Cranar, you feel this very brief, kind of sharp pain in the side of your neck as this thing kind of burrows itself into your... kind of taps itself into your spinal network. And then a moment later, you feel just steady
what
breath.
What have you done to me? Oh. Good. That's really uncomfortable.
Yeah, it just kind of sucks for a moment, and then it just kind of pulls itself kind of into the in between your armor and kind of where your neck and your shoulder is, kind of tucks itself in there.
I do not like this plan.
She squints her eyes. Careful, -5. She turns around.
This will have to go under serious investigation.
Breaststrokes. So many breaststrokes. Some butterflies, you know. We mix it up a little bit.
Alright, so you guys are heading there now?
Yep.
Alright, so it's going to take about an hour to kind of work your way towards where it is, and there's a couple of times you guys kind of have to duck behind some rocks because you see these large, strange shapes kind of moving through the water. But before too long, you guys are able to find the large crag that was pointed out to you before. Basically, it's just a large crack in the floor of the underground lake. And as you start to get closer...
On the way.
You got... You know, oh, yep, go for it.
If they're going to send all their warriors to the merfolk, presumably to fight to the death, they're going to leave this unprotected, and I'm sure they have plenty of goodies... hidden around here.
They leave what unprotected exactly?
Their homestead, where they reside right now.
I sort of give you a sidelong glance. Are you thinking of robbing these people?
I mean, they're gonna die anyways. Why leave it laying here?
You're assuming that they'll die. Well, the Murrow have just as much right to live as the merfolk, don't they?
Yeah, but we're
and right to their belongings. Well, technically, we're not helping the merfolk. We're keeping them from being hindered.
No.
Lily signed you guys up for a battle.
Yeah, we're fighting.
Yeah.
Well...
These are spoils of war. We have
I know, but... I wouldn't call... Perhaps we have a different view of what's happening here. The way that I see it is that we would be defending them against an attack and not an all-out war, hopefully. I mean, I don't know what the intention of the Murrow is at this point. Perhaps they will send all of their forces, but otherwise what we'd just be doing is repelling an attack, which would be not giving necessarily a boon to the merfolk, but rather preventing ill fortune. That's how I see it anyway. Neutrality in all things.
However you see it, there's a side that's been chosen here, and the merfolk and the Murrow are aware of that once this starts.
Well, if they do happen to all die, then we can take their stuff.
Blended.
Because they'll all be dead anyway.
He, leans in. I believe you are a greedy person. I just had to tell you that. Is that...
I won't disagree with that. Is that going to
give me another minus five? I take that back.
All I'm suggesting is that we do not leave what could potentially be very valuable to us to be left behind and covered in dust.
We'll cross that underwater bridge when we get to it.
Or we'll just swim under it.
That as well.
Like you said, Lyric, you don't need to see it if you don't want to lie about it.
Well, as I said, if they're already all dead, it doesn't really make a difference. But I wouldn't plan on robbing them while they're alive.
All right.
So let's just leave it there, I suppose.
Lily starts making mental notes.
I think you got a minus five.
Okay.
I should totally like notes for everyone else, too.
So you guys head the rest of the way?
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, as you guys kind of start getting close to the crack, you recognize the same Murrow that actually met you all when you kind of came into the cavern, one Gorfin. And he kind of approaches you all.
I see you all made the right decision. Have you got the information we needed?
We have all of the information you need, yes.
Excellent. All right.
If you have the shard.
I do not have it.
Got the stuff?
Mela has it. You'll have to meet with her.
Ooh.
When is that going to happen?
I can take you there now, outsiders.
That sounds like a great plan.
Why don't we meet on neutral ground?
That sounds like a better plan.
What do you mean?
It would be best, you know how it goes. As soon as we get there, we're surrounded by your men. We're at a disadvantage politically. We don't have you have the chance then to say, now just give it to us or we kill you.
We are hunters, but we are honorable. And if you are suggesting otherwise, we have no need to do business with you.
Wow.
And since you seem so interested in pulling us out of our lair, that makes me nervous, outsider.
Well, you can bring guards if you'd like. It's not that we want to have you at a disadvantage. We said neutral ground, correct? We just want this to be a fair deal where everybody feels comfortable.
If you wish for our shard, outsider, you will meet with Mela.
We're not suggesting your... dishonorable. We're simply looking out for what's the safest option for us in all cases.
And I'm looking for what the safest option for our leader is, the Seer of the Hidden One.
Yes, I'm thinking this. I'm thinking, that's the excuse they always make. Okay. Yes, are you sure you couldn't bring... I mean, you could even come up with a different place for us to meet as long as we're not in the center of thousands of people that could murder us.
We do not have thousands, and I can bring Slackus out here to speak with you if you wish, but he does not have the shard either. He is the leader of our military, if you will.
I sort of turn to the others, like, should we go? This is always a mistake.
What is this, the carrot on a stick?
I do not understand that saying. What does that mean?
Carrot on a stick.
Is that a way you eat carrots?
No, they're dangling a, you know, enticing, you know, solution to our problems that doesn't even exist.
By the way, is there a way if I make an insight to see if he's just fucking putting on a front about being honorable just so that I
absolutely
don't fucking try to shit on him?
Absolutely.
Okay, I don't fucking know.
You don't particularly know, but I mean, from everything you guys have seen, they have not lied to you yet.
Well, they haven't really done anything that they could lie about yet.
Also true.
Well, I say, we know
that they're loyal. They got a huntress, and she's very honorable.
Yes, the only problem I have is every time somebody gives a deal like this, things go bad. Whenever they say, oh, well, come in the middle of our giant group of people with pointy weapons, don't worry, we're honorable, they always point those pointy weapons at you. But it seems like we've unfortunately come to an impasse. So I turn.
I tell you what, if it would make you more comfortable, I can have her room cleared minus her two personal guards and Slackus. That is the best I can do.
That would make me feel much better, thank you. It's not that we don't think that you are honorable people, however, this seems to be the way that things always go.
Very well.
I mean, and the Lily, I'm like, I say he gets minus five in my book. Is that how it works?
Are we in agreement then?
We are in agreement that we will meet with your leader as long as only the personal guards are there in the chamber with us.
I will be right back. And he kind of swims off, and about 5-8 minutes later he comes back.
Alright, it is done. Follow me.
And he kind of takes you down to the crack, and as you guys are heading down, you can see that there are tons of just kind of little caves that are kind of just carved out of the rock itself. And you can see that there's kind of Murrow watching you guys from a good portion of them, but none of them kind of come out. They all very much seem to be doing what they were told, whatever that might be. He leads you guys to what seems to be one of the larger ones, and even as you guys are approaching, you can see that there's kind of these strange lights kind of coming from within the cavern itself. He takes you to the door, and then he kind of motions you in.
All right, they lie within. And as you requested, it will be just the guards, her, and Slackus. I will not follow.
I don't remember the part about Slackus, but all right. Let's go in.
He did say that.
Yeah, it's basically their general.
Okay.
So, you guys head in, and you guys can see that there's kind of a lot of hunted trophies hanging around, a lot of different kind of fish skeletons, and kind of things that seem to have been collected that they find of value, and you see that they definitely value way different things than the merfolk do. You don't see a single gem or shiny object in here, except for the shard that is sitting in the lap of a very interesting-looking Murrow. It's kind of a smaller, very different-looking. You notice that most of the Murrow kind of seem to be these large, massive kind of almost masculine in figure, whereas this one seems to be kind of the opposite, very slender. And you can see all kinds of bones and ornamental jewelry kind of hanging around, similarly to the Sea Singers, but very different at the same time. And you can see in front of this figure, there is kind of a small glass orb of some sort that seems to have a couple of small animal bones kind of floating in it. And as you all enter, you see that slowly this large Murrow kind of beside her starts to drift forward.
I'm Slackus, Blade of the Murky Depths. We were told that you have the information we seek.
Indeed we do. And do you have the shard?
And he kind of motions to the kind of feminine Murrow that you see, and you kind of hear this very... Similarly to the merfolk, it's a very kind of beautiful, almost harmonic voice that kind of greets you, despite the very rough and kind of twisted appearance.
Yes, we do have the shard that you were promised, and as soon as you give us the information, I will give it to you as promised.
Most kind. Well... are you ready for this information?
Yes, of course.
Suppose we shouldn't get too far into pleasantries.
And you see that she kind of leans forward in her chair, Slackus kind of drifts ever so slightly to side to kind of make a clear line of sight from you guys to her. You can see that her eyes are kind of glowing with a kind of a dull violet energy as well.
This bitch is trying to see if I'm lying. I give her all the information that we were given about where the locations of the thingies are.
The bank, the temple, the town square.
Mm-hmm. And as you guys kind of list them off, you see that she kind of turns and looks across the room, and you can see that there is a man kind of scratching things into a crudely drawn map on the wall with kind of a small bone dagger that he seems to have.
Felifax, did you get all that? Aye, miss, I got all of it.
Very well. You all kept up on your end of the bargain, and we shall do the same. And you see that she kind of reaches down for the shard, and as she does, Slackus kind of spins around.
You're not going to make them fight with us? You're not going to make them help?
Slackus, we made them a deal, and we will honor our word. Our quarrel is not with them. It is with the merfolk who wrongfully cast us out, despite all of the good we did for them and all the protection that we gave them. We are going after them for the schools of our young that were lost, not because of anything these outsiders did. Stand down. You can see that Slack, as he kind of almost seems to growl inwardly for a second, and then kind of just turns away. Almost, you guys can see he's kind of pouting a little bit, almost. And very slowly, the shard kind of starts to drift across the room toward you until it stops very right in front of Lyric.
The shard does?
Yes.
I reach out and very gingerly cup it in my hands. And
I give sort Lyric of, a look.
Sort of weigh it a little bit in my hand, and I look to the others. Does this seem authentic to you?
I inspect it. Said.
Crystal. Oh.
Yeah, it is very much one of the shards.
Looks fucking legit, man.
And just to be certain, you don't have more of these, do you?
No, the Durgar had one more that they'd promised us when we took them back to the other side. It was the only reason we dealt with the scum in the first place. But now that we have no need for the shard any longer, we might as well just leave those fools to drown.
Well, they're dead, so...
Wise words, yes. Well, we appreciate this deal and that you've upheld your end of the bargain so valiantly. And we hope if we see you again that we can come to another amiable deal.
Yes, of course. Happy hunting. I wish you luck in your coming adventures.
Oh, thank you.
Just make sure you don't find yourself anywhere dangerous in the next week.
We hope not to.
If there were future deals, what would you have to offer? Out of curiosity.
Well, I'm willing to bet that you're speaking of the type of items that the merfolk would have. Is that correct?
Some of their items pique my interest, yes.
We have no need for their gems and their petty valuables. We do not treasure gold and gems. We treasure things that can properly be used. Things that help in the hunt.
Things that help with survival. If we crush the merfolk, anything that we don't need is going to be up for trade or be cast into this pathetic crack that we found ourselves tucked into like dogs.
So those weak, pathetic excuses for magic items they've created, you would have no use for.
There might be one or two things that would be valuable to a hunter, but anything else, yes, we have no wish for them.
So, say, beyond 5 or 6 of those items useful to hunters, the rest go to us.
Easily.
Should we help you? Lily gets that, like, that grin and looks at the rest of the group like, this is a way better deal, folks.
I know that you went and scouted things out for us. I'm not sure what front the merfolk may have put on for you. I'm willing to bet my men did not do a very good job at explaining the situation to you all. Is that a fair assumption?
I feel as though they were more straight to the point, exactly.
That is their way. Unfortunately, more clever individuals like me and Slackus here, as well as you lot, we tend to know that sometimes the details are a little bit more important, are they? Aren't they?
Yes, they do seem to help.
They do make a good story.
We spent years working with the merfolk. Originally, it was a war, I will grant you that. There was unrest for a long time. You see, my children are not the brightest, and a lot of times they find themselves hungry for battle, and they don't always choose the best of targets. I was given to the Murrow as a gift by the Hidden One. Some of you may know a deity in her own right, one that lords over some of the more interesting creatures of our world, shall we say. And my... Zarin was the Hidden One. She's depicted as kind of a fey creature.
Well, I'm trying to remember if she was one of the gods that I revered or not. I don't remember.
Likely. I can give you a real quick reminder.
Yeah, I could have sworn somewhere on my sheet I wrote it, but I can't find it anywhere.
Yeah, basically, Zarin is the one that looks after rogues and people that are a little bit... she almost seems to have a... If you talk to her followers, she almost seems to have a kind of split personality of sorts. She seems to support both luck and unluck, as well as fortune and misfortune. It's kind of a strange thing that not everyone really understands. It seems like it's really only information given to kind of the higher-ups in the order of their religion. But yeah, so I was given as a gift so that the Murrow would be able to finally find peace with the Merfolk, a group that, by all means, had a lot to offer. Both of us had a lot to offer each other. We operate on different cycles. They like to work with magic and enchantments and things like that, where our focus was hunting and physical prowess, and my specialties happen to lie more in seeing things that others cannot. Walking in the shadows, being able to do things that are necessary at times. But recently, the merfolk did something that I never thought that they were capable of. They attacked us in our sleep. They used their foul magic and they cast us out of our portion of the city. The part that we had built and colonized. The part that we had stuck to as per the bargain. They kicked us out without any explanation. And in doing so, they damned us to the dark, murky depths that lie beyond the breath of the sea. We lost more young than I care to admit, to beasts you couldn't even imagine. That is why we seek revenge against the merfolk. They took a friendship that had been building for years and years and years, and they spat on it, and they stabbed us in the back.
That sounds terrible.
So I'm looking at the rest of the group, waiting for the nod of approval.
I just give an understanding nod, not a nod of approval. And I say, let us speak in private for a moment, and we may, perhaps this deal might be advantageous to us. We'll have to see if it's in line with our goals.
Very well. If you wish your conversation to be private, though, I would suggest you leave this cavern. I have a very keen sense of hearing.
It's that was my intention, but thank you for warning us. That was very kind of you.
Yes, of course.
So I motion for the others, and they start to walk away or swim away, whichever.
Yeah. And you guys can see that Slack is kind of immediately rushes to her side and kind of seems to almost start arguing with her.
All right, so I just ignore him because I figure Daddy and Mommy need to talk. And we head out and get a good distance away, and then I turn to the others and I say, to be honest, they're probably going to take the items that we would have wanted anyway, and we aren't going to get. I don't think it's more advantageous to us, except I suppose we get more money.
Our mission was to get powerful magic items, and there is a lot of them.
Well, the merfolk did say that they were going to give some to us, didn't they?
Not much.
If you guys helped with the combat.
Well, yeah.
That's what I mean. I want to look around to see if anyone's buying on us.
I do want to remind you guys, just because there was kind of a week break and things like that. You guys did get what they explained as their pride item from dealing with the shark man, Captain Daggermaw, in the temple.
Which was?
The necklace Dev has.
Yes.
I had, but I gave it to him because I'm a nice boy.
It's Talvera's amulet.
And did we figure out what that did?
Plus one to spell DCs, and once a day you can identify. Or once every 3 days, sorry.
Damn, man.
Or was it once a day? No, I think it was once a day.
I don't know. It was my item. It's probably written on his character sheet.
Yeah, I'm sure he's got it written. I'm pretty sure it was every day.
Once every day what?
You get to cast the spell Identify.
Oh, okay.
Or without material components?
Without. It's kind of like a recharging wand, but it's an amulet instead.
Nice.
Alright, so... Oh, yeah! Could we use that to identify what this harpoon that I have does?
You guys already did that, I thought.
Yeah, it was plus one.
What does it do?
Yeah, it was just a plus one harpoon.
Is it considered a spear?
Yes.
Damn, I have to use it then.
You don't have to do anything, my child.
It's only smart to.
Yeah, you guys are underwater. You found proper underwater weaponry.
How many items did the merfolk plan to give us? I didn't hear you.
I don't think there was a specific number.
Yeah, she didn't give you a specific number. She just said some.
I mean, she can give us some, but the merfolk have, or the Murrow have, like, no use for them at all.
That is true.
Which means we get almost
all. Well, no use for the ones that aren't very good for combat, which the ones for combat.
It seemed like they were interested in stuff that was going to help them kind of get close to the prey.
I mean, they're interested in, like, literal weapons, not jewelry, which is what all of their crafted items are, of gems.
Yes, though jewelry is also not so much what the military is interested in.
So all their enchanted jewelry is ours. And they work with gems, which means almost everything they have is enchanted jewelry. I mean, we found some pretty useful items for to help us lessen our footsteps. Or
no, I wanted to ask, can I do a check to see if anyone is spying on us while we talk?
There would be a perception check.
Yeah, I'd be keeping an eye out too, just in case.
14.
Same.
You see that people are watching you kind of from a very respectable distance.
Okay.
You know, we're rolling terrible. They're still kind of hanging out in the crack. You guys have kind of swam up out of their domain a little bit, and they didn't follow.
Fizzy, what are your thoughts?
I do.
Well said.
Same.
-5.
Yeah.
There's a lot of powerful items that can be of assistance to us in social interaction rather than physical. And some that may not be particularly for our physique, but...
Well, the more that we think about it, too, the merfolk aren't really technically, in either situation, the good guys.
No, from the story we were told, I think they're the ones at fault.
Well, I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm trying to remember this because it's been a while. The merfolk told us that the Marrow went crazy one day.
No, they said that they caught the Marrow having dealings with the Durgar, who are known slavers. And that made them worried enough that they felt they had to take action.
Well, they did do that.
They did do that.
In either case, it's of no matter to me.
Yeah, no, the Murrow were very open that they did have interactions with the Durgar, but they also said that they had very specific reasons for doing so.
Are you there, Fizzy? Are you maybe muted, or...
Nah, he's playing with his goat.
Yeah.
He made an Arcana check not too long ago. Maybe just went to the bathroom or something.
Would be nice to have another opinion on this.
We can go ahead and take a quick break for everybody if we want to.
Yeah,
give Fizzy a second to get back.
Jump into something, and I yeah.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
So if we could take a break,
I can fully respect that. So we will take a quick 10-minute break. Hopefully, Fizzy will rejoin us then, and yeah, we will see. And that'll give you guys a couple minutes to kind of think it over as well in your heads and kind of see where you land.
Yep. Okay, I'll talk to you guys.
Sounds good.
Okay. Hey, Brad, you there?
Yep.
Hey, yo, Biscuit.
How's it been, man?
Going. It's going. I'm watching the election as well.
I'm sorry for you.
While I'm doing all this.
So, who'd you vote for?
Oh, God.
Who'd you do it? Who'd you pick?
I didn't pick anyone.
Good. That's better than saying an actual choice. Thank you.
I'm watching the states get flipped. Like Pennsylvania, for instance. There was a whole lot of outcry for the voting machines being rigged. And it looks like it might be true.
Yeah, people are assholes. I hate people. Oh well. As long as it doesn't affect my travel today or my land experience, I'm fine.
Right. The Dow, I don't know if you probably don't care, but the stock market, it plummeted 700 points to give you an idea of how big of a jump that is. On 9/11 when the towers fell. The stock market fell 600 points. That's how, like, unsure That's how unsure they are of this new president.
We're fucked. I'm gonna go get water to drown myself. Beer pack.
Okay, I'm back.
Welcome back. Have you seen anything on this election?
Not a lot. I saw that Trump was leading on a bunch of states, but not all the states and not all the votes are in yet.
No, but it looks like the in Lebanon County, Pennsylvania, which is a swing state, I guess. It looks like some of the voting machines are actually rigged, and they have pretty good evidence that it's happened. Like they go to check or they go to pick Donald Trump, and it just immediately switches to Hillary. It's pretty weird. It's really weird when you watch a video of it. But they said they fixed it, so now that the votes are coming in. But there's no... It's one of the few states that don't have a paper trail for it. So how are, you know, some of the other votes that they voted early? You know what I mean? Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
This is weird. But also, the stock market, it fell 700 points just within the last, like, 4 hours.
Yeah, because people are now realizing we're fucked.
Yeah, it fell more than it did on 9/11. Jesus Christ.
I don't know how you guys stand in politics, but this is a really shitty year.
Yeah, it's kind of ass.
I don't want to get political, so that's all I'm really going to say, but this is a shitty year.
Yeah, yeah. It's like both parties have something like 19% approval or something close to it. So it's like they're voting for a candidate that they don't honestly like.
And that's the flaw of the two-party system. We'd probably be better off like that one country that literally everyone that wants to run for president gets a commercial, then they fucking elect a puppet.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
I actually need to use the bathroom. I'll be right back.
Bullocks.
It's actually a pretty hard decision to make, considering that really only me and Lyric are here to give opinions. Fizzy's missing. And then, I don't know, those new guys. A new guy, so we don't trust him.
Hi. Yet.
And we can't even ask the other two people because they're not here.
You're telling me you don't trust Slingblade over here?
What? What'd you just call me?
That guy.
Yeah.
I will fucking end you!
I don't remember your name, so you didn't update your fucking name on Roll 20, kid.
I'm tired.
I wouldn't be surprised if the officers have a really short session and then try to get everyone's opinion on this matter before we move on. Because at least I'd like to have Xemnas and Dev give their opinion on this.
Now, I don't like it when Ruben's not here. Ruben's a cool guy.
I don't know where Brookie went.
I don't fucking know, dude.
He was on Discord, like, all day.
It's probably, out and about with the selection.
Alright, do we have Fizzy back?
I haven't heard him say anything.
Neither have I.
I'm back.
Yo, Fizzy, if you're here, you're muted.
I have a feeling he went to sleep, guys.
So I'm thinking...
Alright, I'm gonna have Brad try to get a hold of him. Go ahead and feel free to start talking in the meantime, though, because I'm not 100% sure what's going on with him.
Well, I was thinking we might just want to end really early and just have everyone...
We can do that, too?
Down three people.
Yeah, yeah, fair enough.
Technically four, because we don't really have...
I have no matter in this opinion. Conversation.
Yeah. Gabby's gone.
This is all very strange to me.
Yeah, he's just kind of standing around watching you all talk.
Greedy people.
All right, fair enough. Yeah, we will go ahead and end it there for today then. And hopefully everybody will be here next week. I know...
I should be here.
I hadn't heard anything from Dev, so I'm not sure what happened there. But yeah, Xemnas told me ahead of time he would be missing it. So
yeah, let me just say, by the way, really quick, my thoughts on this, because I thought about something during the break.
Yeah, absolutely.
Go ahead. In the game, if we help the Merle, our only way to get paid is complete destruction of the merfolk. If we help the Merle, all we have to do is defend against one attack and we get paid.
You mean the merfolk, if you help them?
Yeah, the merfolk.
Yeah, merfolk. Mm-hmm. If, yeah, sorry.
Well, I'm pretty sure this one fight is going to be like all or nothing.
Yeah, you get the... I mean, just from kind of talking with them, you just get the impression that the Murrow are looking for help with dealing with the Sea Singers real quick. That seems to be their primary concern. They seem very, very confident in dealing with the rest of the Murrow folk. From what you guys have seen, it seems like that is legitimately the only thing that they are actually worried about.
It's like the Song Singers are the warlords, and once you take them down, they're just running around with, like, a chicken without a head.
What you guys have noticed, the merfolk are not warlike people. The only defenses they really have is the beguiling magic of the Sea Singers. And that's one area that the Murrow aren't particularly strong in, which is why the two factions seemed to work so well together when they were working together. So
in one case, we have to hold off against one fight. In the other case, we have to kill the four fucking songstress.
Well, actually, Kranor would, as I know, would say that he would like to side with the merfolk.
Never mind. We can't side with the merfolk. we can't side with the Murrow. I just realized that Gabby's like in love with one of the.
Oh yeah,
I was wondering. Well, I was wondering if you guys would think of that. You guys would have been fighting Gabby.
Yeah,
Gabby's a bad mama jamma.
Right. We'd have to kill Gabby's love and him as well. So never mind.
Yeah, I guess we can.
Fuck you guys.
I mean, we could still hold it up for a vote.
We could tie up Gabby and his girlfriend and throw him somewhere safe.
That'd be terrible. Fuck you, Brad! I gave you too much biscuits for you to fuck.
But yeah.
I mean, they just want to deal with the merfolk. They don't necessarily want to kill them.
You know what that means. You know what? I want to deal with them.
Well, they want their home back.
Which means the merfolk aren't going to give it back.
Well, I mean,
and if they did come to a peaceful end, then that also means we wouldn't get our stuff.
Oh, what? We brought two great communities together. That deserves some fucking praise.
Nobody's asked about that.
Because we already know this isn't going to go well. Alright?
I mean, you don't even know what you know.
I don't know anything. Okay.
I mean, you don't even know what you know.
That I even brought this up and just go kill Gabby.
Or in the words of Al Pacino, you don't know what I know.
You right? You're the DM. We don't know what you
know. Yeah, no, I'm excited though, and yeah, and who knows? There's a good chance that Fizzy, Xemnas, and Ruben all have input as well. So
maybe they're all like, "Fuck Gabby, let's just go kill him."
No. Maybe.
No, Xemnas will not do that. I know him for a fact. I gave him too many damn sunflowers on his horns for him to hate me.
He liked the flower, but think about this: you gave him two flowers. How many conversations did you have in Sylvan?
Hey, he's done that with Infernal, okay?
Because of you guys.
Well, no, he doesn't have to do it.
We only need to kill the songstress. We can just knock Gabby out.
Plus, I healed the fuck out of him, okay?
That's true.
And that's why he won't kill you.
But yeah, you guys can certainly get their input next week as well. So,
yep. Alrighty.
Better be here fucking next week.
Right? Yeah. If not, then
they're not here. We're just like fuck.
I so hope that that Kraynor isn't here next week. You just have no idea if we kill Gabby or not.
That'd be great.
What do they pick? Well, you'll find out next Tuesday.
I just want to know what this fucking -5 means. This is bullshit. I have no idea.
Yeah, no, you've been.
I actually didn't know at first either, but
-5 to what?
Right. Yeah, no, that's
there has
funny.
To be a reason.
Yeah, no, you're role playing Kraynor pretty well so far. I'm enjoying it.
He's had a lot of inspiration.
All right. Well, I suppose I will talk to you guys next week then.